older video of mine, the Spring Hold Boom Mark II. I promised to follow the concept of using coil springs as an energy source for archery with a crossbow. This of course is the result. Today finally we have a day with good weather so I can make the video after a couple months of bad weather. So yeah, let me get in a bit closer so we can have a look at the details of this thing. So how this works is actually relatively simple, although I haven't seen it in this form yet, so that's why I was intrigued by it. And basically the idea behind it is that these coil springs have a limited draw length, in this case roughly 9 cm, so 2 years or so. And of course you want more than 9 cm of draw length for the crossbow, and in this case it's 42 cm. So I solved this by having two small wheels right here, which spool up essentially the string of the coil springs, and these are connected directly via this axle to the larger ones. And the circumference of these is in a ratio of roughly 4 to 1, a bit 4.5 to 1 to the smaller ones. So essentially this works like a lever, like a rotating lever, converting draw force of the springs to draw length, or to more draw length. And of course one main advantage of this is why, and the reason why I was so intrigued by it, is that you can adjust the draw length as you like. So in this case I start at the very front of the crossbow, and of course in a classic traditional crossbow you would have the bow and then the string would more or less start or stop here. And then you would have the actual draw length. So you would lose maybe 10-15 centimeters there. So and in principle you could adjust this as you like. So I could place the trigger hook, or whatever you call this, the nut, even further back and at the very back of this crossbow, and would have the entire length of it as a draw length. That of course is not really possible with a traditional crossbow. So yeah, that's one cool feature about this. So a couple facts and numbers about this thing. The total length of it is 77 centimeters, so very short actually, with a total width of 32 centimeters only. So very compact in all dimensions, as you can see. This thing is really tiny. The total weight of it is only 2.5 kilos. So compared to my last crossbow, which used steel bows, or steel limbs, which weighed I think 4.5 kilos or 5 kilos or so. Huge improvement, and also the last one was very front heavy. And this of course has much more even weight distribution, so handling it is super easy actually, super light. The coil springs together have a maximum, or have a draw weight of 120 kilos. So, and a draw length of roughly 9 centimeters. So, converted through this wheel and axle system, that translates to a draw length of 42 centimeters. With a draw weight of 26-27 kilos. And of course, that's not world record breaking or anything. But of course this is more like a proof of concept thing, the prototype, to see if this principle works at all. And yeah, when I shot this over the crony with bolts that weighed 30.1 grams, so rather heavy actually, it shot them at a speed of 35 to 40 meters per second. Which then means, or translates to, an energy of around 20 joules. And of course that's also not record breaking or anything, but it's already an improvement over my last crossbow, like 50 or 100% more. And also it's more than these pistol crossbows that are quite popular, which have around 10 to 15 or so joules. Let's see how it performs. Cocking this thing is not super convenient because the string of course starts at the very front. so it's hard to reach. And also the angle when you have cooked it is between the two halves of the string is very narrow. You will pinch your fingers. So that's why I made this little cocking eight thing here. Basically just two pieces of scrap wood and the three bolts and the 3D printed piece at the end. And yeah, let me show you. So there you go.
Nice. Not bad.
So now for a couple words on how I built this thing and a couple details. So this is a heavy 3D printed project, especially of course for the wheel and axle system with the main wheels. Also the string stopper thingies. And of course also the smaller ones. And to come up with this specific design, you have to find the balance essentially between weight and strength. And this design that I came up with here, it's a 12 or so iteration using PETG, 100% infill, and otherwise a lightweight construction. Also 3D printed is this whole what I call trigger group, so including mechanical parts like the nut here, which is also 100% infill PETG, and also the grip and the handle and the actual trigger lever here. Everything is 3D printed. Except these two aluminium plates, which transfer the force into the stock. And these plates are CNC'd with a little bit of manual adjustments. And yeah, this trigger group is also a further development compared to my previous crossbow design, because essentially I only need to remove these two bolts. Then I can pull out this whole trigger group and assemble it or disassemble it on my workbench or wherever. And this is a huge step forwards in convenience, because my previous design had to drill through the stock itself. Then of course you have to assemble it within the crossbow itself. That previously was super annoying, super hard to do. Yeah. Besides that, it's just a wooden stock, beech wood, and a couple metal parts like this flat spring to hold down the bolt, of course the springs themselves, and yeah, that's pretty much it. So it's really relatively simple, apart maybe from the 3D printing stuff, but apart from that, relatively straightforward. So it seems to work, and not too bad, I would add. But of course there's still room for improvement. For instance, I could I think I could still reduce the weight of all the moving parts and also reduce friction on them. For instance, I didn't even use ball bearings yet on this, axle system, just steel and wood essentially. And also I could of course have larger springs or double them up, so have a larger draw force. And of course the shape of these wheels doesn't have to be circular, it could be any shape. Essentially, I think I could develop this further into a more compound bow or compound crossbow-like system, which hopefully will also improve performance. And besides that, one would need to add things for convenience. So like I had in my last crossbow, like a cocking lever or something like that, and also a magazine. But I think these are ideas for the next video, for the next project, for the next iteration of this thing. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, or a subscription, or comment, or everything of the three. Then these things are what keep me going, because this channel doesn't create any income. If you'd like to see more like this, please consider one of these or all of them. Yeah, and until then, see you with the next project.